Journalist Kimberly Dvorak. Kimberly, you were down there with a rancher by the name of Jim Chilton, who's been on many networks. He's gotten a lot of publicity because these illegal immigrants and the coyotes are running roughshod over his property, and his property is right next to the border. What'd you see down there?
Yeah, actually, yeah. The Chilton Ranch, they've been down there for, you know, over a century. They, you know, they've seen the border change over the years. And, you know, while the rest of the country wants to say the traffic has really, you know, slowed down, Jim Chilton and, you know, the ranchers in that area are saying absolutely not. And they have hidden cameras on their property, you know, with proof showing that, you know, the drug traffickers as well as the human traffickers are continuing their march north.
I think a lot of Americans don't know how wide open and how porous our southern border is, about 95, maybe 99% of it. You found out firsthand. You have some video. Roll tape.
As you can see, I'm in Mexico. Here's the international border. That's the west. That's the east.
Welcome to the United States. It's that easy.
Is that easy? It's just barbed wire and you just walk right through it. In some areas, there's no fencing at all.
Yeah, and, you know, there were several locations that, you know, I was able to go back and forth across the fence there. And when you see this firsthand, this isn't my first trip down to Arizona. I've, you know, been to several areas along the southern border. You know, I used to cover that, you know, segment a lot. And you see that continually the border's not secure. I mean, that's a barbed wire fence. And if you notice, any of you run the B-roll of this, you'll see that those fence lines are cut over and over and over.
And this guy Chilton, this rancher, has had enough. I mean, he not only has the illegals and the coyotes coming through, but these criminals, these drug dealers, and they are ruining his property and things on his property.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the one thing that most Americans don't realize, I mean, his property, he's got 60,000 acres that he manages there. Roughly 25 miles or so are along the international border. And when that border fence is cut, he has to fix it. And the money comes out of his pocket to repair that. Now, the cartels, you know, they're busy up there on a number of mountain ranges around that area, and they've got cartel scouts up there that are looking to make sure that Border Patrol is nowhere to be found. So, you know, the Chiltons, instead of complaining about the issue over and over again, like, you know, there are a number of people that do so, they've actually offered the U.S. government, and this is astounding, they offered the government the, you know, lease of their, you know, part of their land for $1 a year, so they could actually put a forward operating base, if you will, along the southern border. Because as he explains, he says it's much easier to patrol a linear mile, like 25 linear miles there, rather than, you know, 200, 300, 400, 500 square miles, which the you know, Border Patrol is actually doing right now, because they are so far off the border, they have to now not only, you know, detect once they cross the border there,
right,
they don't get out there and, you know, and grab the guys that we really need to get after.
And that's the ludicrous part. I mean, they might as well not be called Border Patrol. They're off miles from the border. And by the way, it's that way in Texas as well. So you have to wonder, why would the Department of Homeland Security order the Border Patrol off the border instead of being at the border? I mean, if you look at what they did in San Diego in Operation Gatekeeper, and you can see pictures of it right now, it completely secured that sector. Unfortunately, it's only probably 10, 15 miles long, but the apprehensions in that sector dropped almost 90% because of this. It's not just a fence. It's these huge pillars that are about 6 inches apart so no human being can fit through them. If you can do that along one portion of the border, and Bill Clinton did it, Operation Gatekeeper many years ago, 20 years ago, if we can do it there, we can do it virtually everywhere. And for some reason, our government just won't do it.
Well, yeah, and to give you an example, I mean, in Arizona now, the latest excuse is that someone somewhere in southern Arizona spotted a jaguar So now if they put a fence up, the jaguar will not be able to go back and forth in its habitat, wherever it may seem. One jaguar, mind you. So, I mean, these are the issues. So it makes you question politicians. Now, the Cheltons, you know, they've, you know, had politicians, a number of politicians, Jason Chaffetz, you know, and a whole host of them, you know, go down there, and they had Congressman Bishop, I guess, come out and you know, sit down and talk to the ranchers, figure out what they can do to secure the border. There are ways to do this. Yeah. However, there's no appetite. And it seems that, you know, even the Republicans on this aren't as strong as they should be. But that there's no reason that southern border, it should be open. And there's only one reason why it remains. So politicians allow this to happen.
You're absolutely right. If we keep worrying about the animal habitat, we're not going to have a human habitat worth much in this country very soon. No. Kimberly, thanks for that report. You.